Yemen's Houthi militia and Saudi forces traded heavy artillery and rocket fire in the border areas on Monday, a day before a five-day humanitarian truce was due to take effect. Now, the Houthis say they fired Katusha rockets and mortars on the Saudi cities of Jizan and Najran after the Saudis hit Sa'ad and Hajjah provinces with more than 150 rockets. Saudi fighter planes also struck positions on the Iranian allied Houthi group in the central city of Taiz and in the oil-producing Mari province east of the capital Sana'a. Saudi jets bombed a vast compound in the capital Sana'a on Sunday, which is home to former President Ali Abdullah Saleh, a key player in Yemen's political crisis, whose loyalists in the army fight on the Houthi side.
What is happening can't be justified and is jaundiced against the Yemeni people, and I'm one of the people. So, my targeting shouldn't be the targeting of the nation and all of its citizens. They have targeted us from Sadr to Aden and from Hadramaut until Mehdi. So, this is a genocide, a war of revenge and hatred against the Yemeni people.
Well, now, for more on the security situation in Yemen, Zaid al-Alaya’a, a Sana'a-based journalist, joins us by phone from Yemen. And now, Zaid, this strike on the compound of a former president, did it appear like he was being targeted?
Look, the compound of the former president is located in a very populated place where a large number of citizens are living around his house. The missiles that targeted the president did not hit anybody, either from his guards or the president himself was not there. And I think the KS-led coalition, they know that President Saleh was not there, or they know that his big supporters or family members were not there in the house. In spite of that, they hit the house knowing that the place is surrounded by large number of citizens. The citizens' houses were completely destroyed and large number of people got injured. Today in Sana'a at exactly 6 o'clock, a number of airstrikes targeted the Nukum mountain, which is also a very crowded place full of citizens whose houses are very fragile and can be easily broken. I think the casualties of people are in hundreds of people that are injured, and I think the death is in dozens, if not in hundreds. And people talk about that there were some Tomahawk or crows missiles were fired from ships in the sea, and they say that these ships are Americans. What is happening in Sana'a now and in a number of places is very much close to a genocide that is being done under everybody. Saudi Arabia has bribed every single agency, starting from the UN upwards to different countries that are joining the coalition with Saudi Arabia.
Now, Zaid,
I saw children, women in the street crying, and they lost their children in rebels.
Now,
what is happening is very much like a genocide that is
a question here.
Under the eyes of the whole world.
Question here, Zaid, we know that tomorrow a truce is supposed to start. Does it look like it's going to really take place?
If you look at what happened before, they called it the decisive storm, and then they changed the name from restoring hope, and the strikes were stronger and more severe, and now they talk about the truce. I do not trust these people. These people are trying to destroy every place in Sana'a or every place in Yemen. What, even if this war is happening, they managed to implant a sort of hatred and dividing the country into different parties. The situation now in Sana'a is beyond description. It's so crazy. People are walking in the streets, and I don't know about other places. I know there are a lot of
Zaid,
fights taking place
in Sana'a. Yeah. Yes. Zaid, very quickly, is a military approach the solution anymore, or perhaps peace is the only way? Peace talks.
The spokesperson of the military said they will deal positively with any truce that will help in entering some relief agencies. And one spokesperson also from the Houthi political office says the same thing, that they will deal positively with any calls of truce for humanitarian assistance or for humanitarian purposes.
Okay, Zaid, thank you very much. Zaid al-Alaya’a is a Sana'a-based journalist reporting live from Yemen.